To see this man's ass. He's actually in the Rothschild Mafias, and this is one of my favourite songs. Even when my hometown was Tring in Hertfordshire, or even Berkhamsted. Yeah, the crime scene for De Gaulle in World War II. Yeah, and this one's even more of a favourite for mine, because it makes me feel really strong. And my first girlfriend from America loved it too. Yeah, and her name was Schneider, like the woman in the Indiana Jones and the Holy Grail movie. Yeah. Look now, but it's got a luscious redhead in it like Hannah, and she always looks at his ass. Let me show you as we play the music where the linkage to the Mafias comes from.
Watching you while, baby, you've been watching.
quite a few hidden secrets, and you must not tell Hannah Rothschild. You can see how lovely she is, and how quite often she dresses up in German green. All of it, keep it a must. You must keep it a secret. Okay, and she's a lovely person. Right then, so this is on to another female writer now. We'll take you up to where we left off on the men in the tuxedos in the gambling dens, and the rights to have the women and to murder the women. Yeah, that was Rupert Murdoch's new woman. Quite horrific, really. Right then. The shield carried by King David was traditionally believed to be engraved either with the name of God, which if you turn around is dog, and that's the Douglas jokes. Yeah, and there's the seal of Solomon, belly laugh for the Masons. That's Solomon's temple, and all the black and white squares on every floor in every one of the New World Order and the globalized business scams. Yeah, it is the draft board joke for the war dead. And I think this is where we got to. And there's the pictures of the people, yeah, in the elite circles, like James Bond, Sean Connery. All of them are in the havens. All of them live it up with the women hanging off their every every available point of access. Yeah. And the bunny girls have to prance around, and there's two of them. Okay, this is the black or white tuxedos, and the white one is only for conversational purposes. The black fascist one is if you want to shag the women and you want to cut their throats or something like that later on. Okay, and it's associated with a tall, dark, handsome stranger that, like the people that come over your doorstep on New Year in Scotland. When Satan showed up at the Rothschilds, was that Satan appeared as an extremely beautiful man, except his hoofs would be cloven. He would wear a black tuxedo to gamble and play cards. Winnings were sexual victims, and a white tuxedo when coming only to socialise. Okay, and that takes us into the stories about the people that were born in my region with the deformed feet, and all of the cripples in the jokes about the Usual Suspects movie. Yeah. And that is the cripples in several other movies about the mafia activities, and the cripples are usually the cleverest people in the team for a laugh, and that's the launch of the Paralympic Games for another laugh. Because all of the good bloodlines that produce healthy and fit people are almost disappeared now. Like the miscarried children from the evil gender in the marriage. Okay, and it's tragic, the story about the priests and being celibate when they were all good people and they wanted to sign up. Because they're celibate, their genes disappear. Yeah, that's not the blue jeans that Bruce Springsteen wear, and you must not talk about that issue to Hannah. Because my old girlfriend from America, yeah, from the pharmaceutical profiteering and the munitions industry in Europe, yeah, she loved Bruce Springsteen too, and it drove me mad with jealousy. Okay, Graham in Scotland means the devil, I'm led to believe. An excellent research book by a Christian journalist of Jewish ancestry is The Six-Pointed Star by O.J. Graham. That is the hexagram again, okay? And that's a Puritan statement, okay? All of it is interlocked with the religions that are entirely for profit, and most of them already we have disclosed that they're run by the Rothschilds. With lots of help from the Jehovah's and the intermediary people that are already in Palestine carving it up. Yeah, and they worship Jehovah the God, yeah, and they worship Jesus all at the same time. It's a total fraud, the Jesus story. And the naming of them by people on this earth I don't know how they've got the gall to do that. No one can know what the gods are like until you meet your maker. The shield carried by King David was traditionally believed to be engraved either with the name of the dog or the menorah. And that's a laugh for them now, because in the Jewish and Hebrew texts, sorry, the Hebrew and Yiddish texts, you read from right to left. Doggone. Isn't that a funny joke to project at the masters of the universe? Which is why we had the stormy night last night. And there's what the bloody red Rothschild's hexagram becomes when they win Israel, and it becomes the blue hexagram for Israel, and that's the launch of the Knesset. And there's all the candles that we burn as Christians, yeah, at the same period as they are celebrating the Festival of Lights. Yom Kippur happens in December, but it varies like Easter, so that everybody can be in chaos through all of that period where you've got to meet your loved ones at home. And if you've got a Jewish wife, that Jewish wife is obliged to stay Jewish, and the children should become Jewish, which is something of a dilemma for my ex-wife. She's completely treasonous, and she's proclaimed that her brother is a Jew, and it is all a total stitch-up. Yeah, and all of the rules of their religion are just as twisted as the Christian ones. Many of them are the same. Their Sabbath's on a Saturday, and we explained that in the last video. Okay, so every messianic religion is for profit. Okay, Psalm 67. Siegel, Richard, and Carol Rhymes, Metamorphoses of a Tree. Yeah, it's just the wood joke again. And there's the Bantam Books bit that we found just before we closed in the last video. So there's Rupert Murdoch, and there's the new woman, Hall, yeah, who's been brought in to cover up all of the crimes of the Hall that was the funder for Hitler in the lead up to the Anschluss in Austria. Yeah, and that is the Bavarian crime scene for all of these people. And for the Americans, it's Arnie Schwarzenegger's region of birth. He ends up in California, which is the Calvary Hill joke for the Yanks. Okay, so Kabbalistic, okay? Yeah, all of the false religions are all written by the same people, and the Masons are the people that do all the damage, because they work for both sides, like the intel organizations, and all of them are run by the Rothschild family. Yeah, they run, they own the monarchies, they own everything, and we've told you all of that before. So let's get a Gildy on, okay? And there's Taze Russell's letter from Palestine, the Later Day Saints today, and Charles Cribner's son. Okay, and there's the Malstein Anka, who's the authoress for this bit in the middle, which quite frankly is only about warmongering and fearmongering, but it means that the countries that are involved in the Cold War debates and arguments are capable of extinguishing human life and animal life on this planet hundreds or thousands of times over, because they've got massive nuclear weapon munitions stashes all through the Cold War period, all through the period immediately after World War II. And that is the policy that these sad bastards prescribe in the Protocols of Zion. And a lot of this, so Hitler used that against the Aryan races and the white master race, okay, and the blondes like Murdoch has now acquired, okay, the Rothschild Trust. That is the present objective of Jeroboam Rothschild and his secret elders of Zion. All of it is the power of the pen. And I showed you the papyrus with the blue ink, and when you look up the Piso company now, which is a subsidiary of that Pazers, I explained in the last video that you find that the Piso family still use ink, and it's the product from their factories. If we get down to the bottom tabs, and there's Frankfurt, where they came from, that's the hot dog joke. And all the way through the Right Stuff movie, which is this movie,
yeah, about the space program, yeah, featuring Barbara Hershey, who's in the Hannah and Her Sisters movie, and she's one of my favourite actresses, okay? And her lookalike in the region is an actress too, but because of the frauds of the media up here, and the lottery frauds, where they're claiming that there has been another attempt to defraud the real winners of 33 million of the 66 million that they won, yeah, it's all totally twisted, and even that story has changed in the last few days, because they're changing it to cover the death of Eva Cassidy and the death of Jesus Christ and the death of Alexander the Great, all at age 33, okay? That's why they want it racked up to 66 million. So some innocent person has been picked to be persecuted for that. And there's the Frankfurters, and there is the penis in the sandwich that is the loaves and fishes joke in the New Testament. Yeah, Jesus preaching to the masses with two fish and five loaves. Yeah, and he's able to feed them all. And in the sieges of the castles, it's a human penis, because the people inside are starving. They try and escape and find food for the starving family. They get killed, they get their penis cut off, they get basted into the bread, and then it gets launched with the baristas, or the ballistas, over the castle wall into the starving people inside. And that is a huge joke for the American nation and all of the world. Okay? And that's the fish, yeah? That's the fish in the Rothschild's gardens of the great estates owned by the Rothschilds. Let's see if we can get to the bottom and get it finished. There's Frankfurt now, as is. It's a massive, massive Babylonian epicentre for financial services fraud and for dismembering the world by all of the scams that they perpetrate. Yet, on a minute to second time scale now, the laundering operations. And we told you in that first video that the Rothschilds determine the price of gold all over the world in the first few hours every day of the week. Yeah, it's absolutely tragic that they are able to get away with the ownership of every staged democratic front. There is no democracy anywhere. There's only totalitarian rule, which is why Stalin was demonized by FDR, and why FDR died really young too. Yeah, because Stalin is his mate in the profiteering teams, and all of the training hubs I've explained to you multiple times in recent videos. Okay, and here's the rise of the private courier systems for the French fucking Rothschilds. Okay, Baron James, the rise of the French Rothschild. And that's Baron James, I think, that was involved in the student loans crisis and the student loans or the student union leadership issues, okay? And the launch of those immoral, yeah, get your kit off when you're at university plans. And that's just like the drugs craze that Richard Branson is still in charge of as the drugs czar globally, okay? And there's Count Egon Caesar, the rise of the House of Rothschild in Boston, okay? So they're in America. That's published in 1972, and already the article below is on carbon arianism, yeah, the global warming scam. Okay, that's Carl Quigley. This is about Catholicism and on the New World Order, except that it leaves out the Catholic Church and the Jesuits' participation at a time that their participation was increasing dramatically. That's the new genocidal pope from Latin America. Yet he's a Jesuit. All of that is Ignatius and the warlords in Spain and Portugal. Yet they're warlords, they're lethal killers through all of the historic period. And they move around Europe and eventually they arrive in Britain. And all the sectarian jokes are in place so that the slaughter, the absolute slaughter, continues relentlessly. And that could be the basis for Adele, but I don't know. Okay, and there's the Allen joke. Every time you see the Allen, it's and Fitz Allen, it becomes the Allah, the menace of the Islamic faith, launched by the Pizzos too. Okay, Nixon's palace guard. Okay, so that's all just the citations. And did you notice that when I revealed that there was a Spring family and it becomes the Springsteens, that the article was written by a Spring? Okay, this is accurate. This is the blight of the world. It's the launch of the attempts to twist everybody's mind with the blue ink out of Canaan. Before I went to New Zealand, Billy Connolly, the Joker, yeah, the elite Glaswegian riveter, yeah, married to the Aussie wife, yeah, she understands, and both of them laugh at the Mr. Bean Anzac War Dead joke, yeah, and that is, he made a video on YouTube about fucking blue, yeah, and all of the menace of the blue dyes, yeah, and that's what the Picts have on their faces. He's a total traitor to the working man. And he danced around this week with the one who's in the movie about the Washington Post. I forget his name. Robert Redford, and I can't remember his name. Okay, and he plays the cripple in the Odessa File and the Midnight Cowboy movie. Okay, and he's a clever fraudster. He's a mobster, like Virgil Kint in The Usual Suspects. Yeah, the same template all the time. They're incapable of moving away from it. I got bored with reading about the terror threats and the totalitarian and the fake communists that they launch all through the story, as the Rothschilds family, the world's richest institution. Okay, so the Mullins guy must have been greatly hated, because he gets the stuff out. Okay, England under the heel of the Jew, all of it is about demonising your neighbours all the time, all through human history. And this is the land of Zog joke, which is partly the Fifth Element movie, one of my favourites, yeah, about the ending it all coming from the heavens. And that's what they've launched into the newspapers this week, that there is threats of new viruses, new infections in sub-Saharan Africa, but there's a threat that a new planet is coming. And I think the land of Zog was the place where they went for their entertainment, to the casino-like place at the end of that movie. Okay, and that's my reiteration that that is there. And look at the linkages of the massive university frauds. Yeah. And that's the Cambridge people that launch the spies into Russia so that Russia never ever can be free. Where does Nazism fit into Satan's plans? How very ironic it is that in all the twisted thinking and reasoning of the leading Satanists for why they must do things, it is surprising that they do not catch on that this plan of Satan's is going to achieve God's revealed plan. Yeah, did you follow that? Yeah, it's plot and counterplot, and they reckon that in the course of time, if we have enough world wars with enough nuclear weapons to go round, that we'll arrive at an organised system. That is the plans that every side works to. Yeah, every political party has got that dream, because all of them are tenanted, the political parties all around the world, by idiotic Freemasons that like to shag and kill things, yeah, and they like to kill their own kids, yeah, or the kids of their neighbours, yeah, but the elite kids escape all the time, and that's the draft board black and white joke. Right then, so be wise as serpents. Out of the battle between the two, yeah, the Christ and the Antichrist, or the devil, or whatever you want to call it, it is just the power of the pen to scare the shit out of and propagandize and demonize the world's neighbors. None of them live in peace because of the Masons that are intertwined with them. God's anvil is Canaan, yeah, and that's the writing story, yeah, and that's the story that gives the Masons hope that if we continue to be chaotic like we've done, and we can continue to have global conflict that gets the numbers down, yeah, that's the you'll be there joke for Faith Hill. We'll be there, yeah, yeah, about all of the aircraft people, all of the people that go to their deaths, the loved ones, yeah, it's a huge joke for the world leaders. Three world wars would, out of the battle of chaos would come a new order, reminding us of the Masonic slogan, order out of chaos. Yeah, they were right in the chaos now. Can you see that? Everybody's in debt to the world leaders that write these protocols. If the thesis were like a hammer and the antithesis like an anvil, that was caught in between would be broken or reshaped. Yeah, and remember the anvil stories about the sword being in it and the Canadian frauds with the sword being in the lake. Yeah, they will not go to war in Canada because they're really clever. And I will grieve for Miss Celine Dion's dead husband this week. Three world wars would enable the plan to work. The hammer would be constructed and then given a homeland, a secure base in Russia. Have you heard of the demonization of Russia since FDR died really young with the polio already afflicting him? It's the hammer and fucking sickle joke. All of the warmongering and fearmongering through all of that period since 1946. It was only months later that FDR died. Yeah, and he's the one that turned on Stalin and called him the totalitarian menace. They were trained in the same institutions and they worked to the same plan as the world's Masons all through. And he's the one that raises the laughs in the lodge because he's the Delaney's donkey, and the Delaney's donkey ran the half mile race, and I forget what the other creature is that is in the jokes that all the Irish people sing. That's Dunican, Delaney's donkey and Paddy McGinty's goat. Yeah, so there is the hammer and the sickle, and that is the Canaan joke about the writing tools and the papyruses, and all of it takes you back to the Pisos who launched the Bible, and that is, before Hitler arrives, the favourite symbol for every lodge in every country all across the world. It's still used in India. It's in India on all of the walls that I've travelled through, the massive towns where the poverty is unbelievable. Yeah, it is absolutely riddled the whole world with wealth divide. And he's got the fucking Piso pipe in his hand. 2,000-year-old joke at the world's expense, and the Masons have to adhere to it. Otherwise, they might not get their friends to buy them a drink, or they might not get their finger up the C-word of the prostitutes in the back room. And the Mithraeum, Field McConnell, who's going to interview me fortnightly, so that we could put the world to rights. Right then, it's what we call communism in America. Yeah, it's a laugh. There are no communists anywhere. Gordon Brown is the archetypal communist, absolutely plump person, incapable of doing anything other than demonizing all of the things that happened to Malala and all of the things that the Pisos wrote 2,000 years ago. Okay, the first anvil would be created out of economic chaos in Germany, totally premeditated. It would, and done in the lodge, in the underground, in the great cities that are the losers of the war, that the people in the lodge are the profiteers, like the people in the Fleming family and all of the corrupted admirals and generals and field marshals that were trained to to be lethal insider killers and massive profiteers. Yet at every country except their own tax havens' expense, it would be called National Socialism. That anvil would be destroyed in a Second World War, but another anvil would replace it, called democracy. The first two world wars accomplished exactly what they were intended to accomplish. Do you get that? That's a triumph for the world's thinkers and strategic planners. Okay? Out of the First World War came a secure satanic dictatorship in Russia. Goal number one. Goal number two, the satanic family of Rothschilds gained partial control over Palestine. Goal number three, weapons of mass destruction and terror. Yeah, and that is me that has written that in purple for change, is Iraq, Antioch, hand grenade. That's the Iraq hand grenade and the Iraq mass destruction scams of the weapons inspectorate and all the cover-ups and all of that being fudged by the Warwick rules and all of the totally twisted weapons inspectorates which are led by Germans. And that is the joke in the Out of Africa film about the man who gets the syphilis. The man who's in the Bush and Blair inspection team has the same name, for a laugh. Antioch hand grenade is the launch of the Christian missions, and it's all the same fucking story, and it's all about genocide and how constructive that is as a plan for world leadership. And we're just working on the plan to create World War III. Isn't that clever, Tom Weatherston, John Lamont MSP, and the Borders councillors? Really, really clever. David Murray with the donkey fields is laughing already at the Antioch hand grenade joke. Okay, so FDR died really quickly after he called Stalin a totalitarian menace, and all of them will stick the knife in their own backs, yet without a second thought. And that's why Stalin, labelled as a socialist, had a withered left hand. God knows everything, and the weather patterns are quite fascinating for me at the moment. Okay, four, goal four, the League of Nations. Yeah, the peace-loving countries, allegedly, out of the Second World War, came and won the enlargement of their secure base in Russia into a world power. Okay, so that's immediately after the war. You've got Russia as a divisive tool at the hands of FDR, yeah, who was on the Mayflower, and his family are total religious fraudsters, and he's the one who wrecked the economy using the New Deal. And his name, when they were on the Mayflower, is the Delannoy joke. That's the New Deal in his name. Yeah, and everything means that every American president is not selected by the people, it's selected by the scamsters and the fake counts and the busted Chad issues on the electronic voting. Yeah, and the whole world is just a lie. Just a lie. Okay, and the gods know it because they have to look down on it, and all the jokes about them being the dogs. Yeah. Tic-tac-toe, do you get it now? Yeah, that's the devil's joke as they move through Chinatown, and he talks about where is the tic-tac-toe story. Okay? And in the Jewish nations, you read the words backwards, and it's in the Amadeus film. Okay? Air power, including long-range missiles, this is their goals, all of it. Yellow Kevin. Yeah, Kevin is the devil's advocate, and this is the devilish plot by all of the Jews and the Christians and all of the other religions, as much damage as they can do. Yeah, and all of them, as they do all of the evil construction of these weapons of mass destruction and human extinction, they profit from it. And I've got all their boardroom numbers for the ones that are still alive. air power, including long-range missiles. Do you remember the movies about the war? Do you remember the little doodle bugs coming across? Okay, secret flying saucers and powerful submarines, all items that individuals could not produce. Yeah. That's why I kind of pine for the days of Adam and Eve. Just a couple of innocent people and no pains. Those in control of production would therefore control all air and seaways of the earth. The Cold War and an era of terror. Yeah, that's in the British and French colours. To convince the people of the need for Satan's one world order. Okay? And the stories I've told you about the creation of Europe as a fraud and a chaotic creation. You've seen the goals, I can't remember which number it was, yeah? And you've seen that all of that is managed by a man called Gran, who's a body double and a lookalike for Gracchus in the Roman court. Yeah. And Lord Kerkenbrocker is in charge of all of the dismemberment of it, and everybody in these teams is able to tuck their money into the suitcase and get it into the P2 banks run by the Masons. HSBC and all the honkers and chonkers things and all of the massive banks that they've got that are now affiliated to the racing track. Yeah, that is the red coloured Santander, and that's fucking non-existent St Andrew. Billy Connolly in the lodge. Out of the Third World War would emerge a new religious system. The Third World War would be tailored to the like, to be like the Bible's Armageddon. So all of the project has been destroyed because folk like me and Peter Eyre and Gordon Bowden, to a limited extent, have come forward and exposed their plots. Yeah, I'm going all the way, right up to the commanders-in-chief in those massive mansions in Hertfordshire, Bucks, and all of the no-bombing zones that the cowardly profiteers inhabit, like de Gaulle. Yeah, Satan told his highest slaves, if it resembled Armageddon, then the people would believe he was the Messiah when he came after its end. So they rendered the world extinct and the Messiah's allowed to thrive. And every one of the Messiahs before that is a fake. And because they've got bunkers underground, what they've done is they've brutalized the paradise that the gods gave us. And that's why we're getting the storms that we're getting now. They've looked down on the human activity and the jokes about the gods in the heavens, and it is too much to bear over all of that time. I don't know why they went to sleep, but all of that is portrayed in the Lord of the Rings movie, and all of the world leaders are portrayed in that movie too. And that book, Richest College in Oxford, written there by Tolkien. It would have been terrible so that he could step in and bring the miraculous order out of a world beaten into chaos by the worst war in history. That's our immediate future. Did you realise that that was on the cards? Again, it would be order out of chaos, as the Masonic documents repeatedly proclaim. That's how the world is run, Angela Merkel, and all of the people that are entirely in the crime scene as Muppets to the moneylenders that are still the Rothschilds. And I did not know about the Spring family until this morning. Yeah, 3 o'clock this morning. The Third World War would come during a period of 7 years of tribulation, starting in 1992 and running until 1999. Do you remember the 7 year famines in Egypt when Joseph, yeah, is the coat of many colours joke? Peter Eyre told me this, that this is just the repeating storytelling, and that is the ISIS myths, and ISIS is now a terror organisation. Yeah, and that's what the world leaders are. They are the terrorists, they are the killers, they are the financial profiteers, and they're the monarchies. And they need to steal other people's children so that their siring chambers can work. And that's the consanguinity index, Lady Jane Grosvenor. Yet you did a good job for the Duke. Yeah? I'm looking forward to meeting you again. One of the world's most decent people, I hope. Satan told his followers in 1992 to 99, tribulation would repeat on a larger scale the plagues of Egypt. Yeah, that's the locusts. Yeah, and what we're talking about are nuclear weapons. Only a couple of them will do the job. By giving back in a bigger way to the world what happened to ancient Egypt. Okay? That is the Bush-Windsor family policy and becomes the Cleopatra film, with Dr. Doolittle playing Caesar for HRH's amusement in the 1960s. I forget what the actor's name is. Yet you watch it again and all of it is a combination of the occult, and even then it's spying through the from the back room through the panelled buildings, and all of the buildings that I worked in with the Bristolians and Liverpudlians in Dunedin, they were panelled, yeah, so that no one can keep anybody's secrets a secret. The trick that was the Rothschild master plan. Okay, and there's the papyrus that is the ruin of the world. The creation of God's anvil in Canaan, then East Sussex by H.G. Wells. That's the H.G. Wells that was in the War Office through World War II, scared the shit out of North America with his Martian stories, and that's why they put him in the War Office. And he lives in the same town in East Sussex as Guy Fawkes, the revolutionary like me. And Guillaume, William the Conqueror's mates in the lodges ever since. And they've got the Holy Grail already, and all the jokes are the same jokes. For most of us, the idea of such pain and destruction seems like demonic madness, which it is. At the core of the one world system is Satanism. It hides itself behind fronts such as Jewish finance. God is money for them. Yeah, I don't know whether or not there is a Satan. And if it is someone, I would believe that it would be Arius Calpurnius Piso, the cleverest but evilest man that ever lived on this world. The conspiracy, I'd like to make him famous now, because only the elites know about him. And it's time to end it. Hannah Rothschild, hope you're aware of that. Sorry that I'm demonising you personally. You realise that it's only partially serious. You look like one of the more innocent parties in that family, and that is the key to the future. This is nonsensical and absolutely headed for human extinction. Really clever plan. The conspiracy to create the one world system has enlisted the help of almost everyone. That is because most of the religious systems at the top are controlled by Satanists. Your family, Hannah, are according to these allegations, who know what they are doing and direct the people's religious efforts. Yeah, manipulate the minds and steal the world from them, and bury them and profit from all of that. Read the research in Be Wise as Serpents. Nazism was a pagan Gnostic religious system with the swastika icon, yeah, which was stolen from the Freemasons. Yeah, and the high priest Hitler, yeah, and you know where Hitler was trained, in the West Country in England, at fucking Tavistock. It's all about the power of the pen. For that reason, I'm going to go down to the bottom. Yeah, and then I'm going to go to bed and read the rest of it, and we'll make those whistling, howling noises that the wind made last night when I was finding out what our world leaders aspire to through all of their time in office. The Jewish people, one, use the term in its broadest sense and are being used. Okay? Can you hear the wind howling? Okay, so the Jewish people are being abused, the Christian people get abused, everybody gets abused. The world leaders get to sit in the bunker, and when they come out, there's nothing left. That's the plan. That's the gist of it. Okay? First, the plans are to create a religious leader that will have the apparent credentials of the Jewish Messiah. How sad, because the actions of the Rothschilds and other satanic Jewish bloodlines during World War II show that their first allegiance is not to the Old Testament and not even to Orthodox Judaism, but is purely to Satan. Who are those bricks for, Kevin? Question mark. Yeah, mass murder for that. And that is now, yeah, the biggest scam in the financial services world, because it steals everybody's sovereignty. Yeah, and the Greeks are now getting demonized for it again. And that's the Papandreou fascists that stole all the money over two generations and tucked it away in America. Georges. Yeah, and his kids are likely to end up in the Paralympics, because that's what the gods do best. They spot the culprits and they punish them. You need to be aware of that. Don't know why they went to sleep, but they're wide awake now and howling through the night. Basket of currencies, gold bars. Okay? Right then. This is what they live for. Yeah, and that's the Michael Caine Cockney jokes. And so I got sick of it, because it's all about the same, yeah, scare the shit out of everybody on this earth and let's pretend that we are visionary leaders. Okay, they are being taken for a ride, and then they will be dumped by the New World Order's dictatorship. Constance Cumby correctly notices that the New Age movement resembles Nazism exactly to the joke that is the Christian T, which is the Christian cross. And all of them on all sides, Jewish, Christian, pagan, even Islamic, yeah, and all of the Moorish nations, all of them, the leaders, understand that Jesus is a joke, and the predecessors for their religions, which have the same names, like Joseph in every one of them, yeah, it is just the replaying ISIS myth. Peter Eyre, thank you for teaching me that. And I remember asking you fervently why you think you got your cancer and how that tallies with my conspiracy theory that all pathologies are given us by God if we are not doing the decent thing for the whole world as much as we can. So it's all with the pain, but the weapons of mass destruction threat is real, and that's extinction. And that, for Charlton Heston, was the movie about only the monkeys surviving the nuclear blasts. I forget what it was called. May God open the eyes of the Gentiles to truth and carry his holy gospel to the ends of the earth. That's the book. And those are my exclamation marks. Yeah, the book is the piezo fraud, which is the biggest fraud of all, the biggest cause of human death in human history. And Karl Marx gets it in the neck all the time. Let's find him and see how they demonize the commies. Oh, and this is terrible, because I've got one in the garage. After creating international socialism, communism, a temporary antithesis was created called national socialism. Yeah, that's fascism is Nazism, wouldn't you agree? Hitler goose-stepping around, ranting at everybody, all of the people in death camps being shot dead on the declaration of anyone without any form of hearing. Yeah, that's called socialism. That's sharing your assets with your neighbours and your friends and your workers. Yeah, both of them are labelled socialism. The process to create national socialism was to turn again to the Masonic lodges and other esoteric secret societies to get it done, Field McConnell. Therefore, the secret esoteric, Gnostic and satanic societies, along with the Illuminati, helped create the fucking Thule Gesellschaft, in English, the Thule Society. I could take you to the garage and show you my roof rack, and that's the roaster's joke for the All Black rugby players. Yet the roasters in Dresden, the clearing up of the bodies by firebombing that massive treasure littered town, because it's got all the art treasures, yeah, and it is one of the world's greatest tourist venues. I forget what they call the most wondrous tourist venue. Alexandria was famous as the light of the world for its massive lighthouse, and that was what, when Charlton Heston visits the human beach, yeah, where the extinction has occurred with the monkeys all around him, all that he finds is the light of the world has survived the cut. And that will be, I believe, the Statue of Liberty, yeah, which is in Eva Cassidy's joke too. Quite a lethal joke for that person. Right then, so there's the Thule rooftops rack that we have, yeah, and there is Adolf Hitler was some type of member of this occult Thule society, along with many other men who later began leading Nazi leaders such as Rudolf Hess, yeah, the Hamilton country dancing connection to the monarchies in Britain. I forget what it was, the Hamilton waltz or something, yeah, that is the dispossession of the land by the kings and queens in Britain, and he tries to stop the war, but it's only his body double, and he spends his whole life, the body double, in jail, yeah, because they get conditioned at Tavistock and they are basically just robots. The Thule Society used the Masonic Hindu symbol, the swastika, yeah, and I've got one in my garage. And I learned that in New Zealand, I was quite shocked. And there is the swastika symbol, and there's the man that was killed by HRH, because he released all of the news that this is a perfect template to create a chaotic world that you can own entirely, yeah, and when you've got NATO's armies and the Rothschilds working on the siring of your family, even if you're the Queen. Yeah, they get to sire them, it's done under date rape drugs, and there's one of the persons that did it. Okay, it's tragic, yeah, the whole of it. And there's totalitarian Stalin, who was a friend of Churchill's and FDR's when the war started, and Beaverbrook is looking down on all of them and writing it up as a triumph for the free world. It's just butchery for the hell of it. In other words, World Heritage Site, that's Dresden now, they've converted it again, they've built it up from the rubble, and it's beautiful, and it's on the Danube, and it's absolutely lovely, and that's the start point for the next great conflicts, Austro-Hungaria. In other words, the grandmother of the Nazi party was the Masonic lodges in Germany. Here's my one true love coming in Germanic green. Okay, the Vril was another secret occult group. Isn't she lovely? I don't think that's her. She's lovely. Right. And hopefully she has a conscience and might be prepared to speak to ordinary people about people being ordinary and being able to live centuries ahead without having these manic desires to render the human race extinct. Was part of an organised plan. The Vril was another secret occult group that many of the Nazi leadership belonged to, all of them trained in the English speaking world. Yeah. And funded, all of them, by this same family. Can you hear the winds rumbling outside? It's quite spooky. Hitler was also a member of the Theosophical Society, which has strong satanic and Masonic ties. Both Bailey and Hitler studied. Yeah, everything I love is killing me. Yeah, hopefully my next pick is going to do better. They also both studied the Gnostics and every major pagan occult religious system. All of them are that. All of them are frauds. And thank you to the Jehovah's for meeting me in your boiler suit and looking, even the Bristolian ones, looking a little bit sheepish about what I've revealed in the last 2 weeks. Yeah? And I was expecting a call from the sectioning doctors again. It has not happened yet. They will be very, very nervous because these are their beliefs too. That's people with 2 degrees, yet that trained to be a doctor and trained to be a policeman first. An example of how valued the swastika was for Freemasons before Hitler ruined its image is a quote from Joseph Fort Newton, like Newton's St. Boswell's with David Murray's donkey field next door, which is Jesus in all of these jokes, a Baptist minister and high-ranking Mason, like the whole of the Boswell's community. Thank you to the people who gave me a lift when we had the second or third biblical flood in 3 weeks. The second of these volumes also contains an essay by Thomas Carr. Okay, and that's my comments about my in-laws in Boswell's, the ovens, even in the Boswell's lodge, and they marry my cousin. Yeah, because the Rothschilds always try and choose the pure bloodline by marrying their closest cousins, which is a very insecure thing to do, and which is why they have to steal other people's kids. And why the head of midwives is now the head of the pharmaceutical society, which I can't afford to be in as a fellow. So Joseph Fort Newton, a Baptist minister and a high-ranking Mason, the second of these volumes also contains an essay by Thomas Carr with a list of lodges and a study of their history, customs and emblems, especially the swastika Arthur Hasty. You knew that as well, I presume. And Hitler is trained in Liverpool and is an Everton supporter, like my cousin Chris. Speculative Masons are now said to be joining, seeking more light on what they are called the lost symbols of Masonry. After promoting and using the swastika for years, the Freemasons quit using it after Hitler. But they continue with the profiteering, and that's on that tag about Max Goldsmith Rothschild in the lodge in Munich. And they now drink in the Tory Club in Jedburgh. Okay, so I got bored with it. It's all about scary stories and all totally negative. And here's Mahatma Gandhi. I don't know where he trained. Yeah, and all of the people that get assassinated. Yeah, I don't know whether or not they actually get assassinated or whether or not it's just false news stories. That's Michael Grade's sector, Phoenix Films sector, and all of the leaders of the Deutsche Bank sector. I don't know whether or not that man Craven is actually a Mason. I would very much suspect that he is. Okay, and Satan, I doubt very much that there is anybody called Satan anywhere on this earth, but only time will tell. Every day I learn something new. And it's really exhilarating compared to molecular neuroscience and inventing new drugs. And that's what the other Billy Connolly does, one of the most intelligent people on the world. Yeah, and he's allowed to dismember all of the women that he's involved with, and he's allowed to dismember every country that he visits. And his dad's got Irish roots, and all of it is treasonous. And they all think they're really clever to be in the inner circle doing things like that that may lead to human extinction. And there are some famous Nazi names. Yeah, and all of them, yeah, are trained by the Brits. Lord of Lords, King of Kings, and that's the Rothschilds. Okay, so that could be about the siring, and so Hitler's Antichrist spirit will get plenty of demonic help. Okay, and I don't know what they did in the tuxedos, but I'm quite pleased that there's no details on that. Let's get down to the stuff at the bottom, on the shocking stuff that we must keep Bruce Springsteen's ass out of Hannah's visual line of sight. Okay, it's quite stunning. And you saw earlier the relationships of the Spears, yeah, that's Britney Spears' launch, and that is Albert Spears in the Third Spears in the Third Reich. Yeah, every one of the Rich List members has to be covered up. And I think we got round to showing you this morning Ellison, or that may be further down. Okay, I think it is further down, so let's get a move on. So, by Fritz Springmeier, Smith of David J. Smith. Rothschilds are one of the most well-known of the 13 families. David J. Smith of Portland was asked to prepare an article on them for this newsletter. His article follows this introduction. Satan's selective breeding program has been continuing down through the ages, okay, hidden from the eyes of the public. One of the most powerful Rothschild bloodline families in America are the Springs. That's Zebedee. Yeah, the Springs were originally the Springsteens, Brucey. Yeah, and the connotations of the Bruce name take you back into the Scottish treason. So, theirs is ass. Do not look, Hannah. Okay, and he looks as if he got his hot water bottle in his pocket. When they came to America in the mid-1700s and settled in New York and New Jersey, they later changed the name from Springsteen to Springs to hide their identity. And there is Zebedee and his mates. And there is Dylan, that was the son of Michael Douglas. And that's Michael Douglas, who makes the movie about the rabbit in the sink and shags the woman that is the girlfriend of Jim Dale in the sink. And Jim Dale is the actor who plays Brian Hall, the peace protester on Parliament Green, until he gets his cancer. I don't think he sang about immortality. Okay? If that's what it takes, Celine, sad that your husband has gone. Yet when you sing all those songs about being immortal, and you're related to the aristocracy all across Canada. Okay, and there's Doug. God. Yeah, the jokes are relentless. What other characters are there? I forget what the other names were. You've got the cow, and you've got the Brian the snail, the bee Arian. Yeah, that's the life of Brian. And that is she a virgin out the window. Leroy Springs was hired by L.C. Pazer. Yeah, now most Americans have to ask, who is L.C. Pazer? It made me think that it may well be the Pezos. Yeah, that's the peso emphasis on Latin America and the currency ever so slightly changed. Okay. One of the most secret and most powerful families in North America has been the Pazels, okay? And I've got all of the pages for their directorates, and some of them are Pazos. And let's see, so we got for Pazer, I found 14 results. Ann W. Pazer, PLLC, North Carolina, Belmont. Okay, that's Hester and Pazer, John Pazer Innovations, Lewis Cass Pazer Trust Incorporated. So only 14 results, and nothing really sinister there. Yeah, and then the tax avoiding places and the laundering places. They're in Minnesota, where one of the 26 central banks are. Thank you, Betsy, for smiling at me on that issue. Thank you for giving me the info in the first place. He did not respond to the Buffalo Girls disclosures. They work with ink in Murdoch's America. Okay, this is another search for Pazer, and it is Anita Pazer, Ink Resources Inc. Yeah, Anita Pazer, Ink Resources Inc. Angela M. Porces, half shell, where's my shell? Yeah, carried by all of the missionaries to be used as a trading tool. Isn't it beautiful? That's from beautiful New Zealand. That does not belong to anyone in New Zealand. Okay, so the piezo derivatives are still trading in the pen and ink sector that is the blight of the world. Boswell, Unipiezo, Alabama this time. And this will be the PayPal stuff. And one of my correspondents on all my lists, yeah, every email I've sent goes to Thinking Professionals, and the PayPal boss is on that, and he's been quite interactive compared to many of them. Okay, that's money lending. They have been so powerful that they could hide their wealth and power and use other satanic families as proxies. Okay, and I could look at the piezo tab and show you where the piezos are. They're all over fucking New Zealand, and that's the God Defend New Zealand song. Yeah, everything is totally reliant on the gods, because the humans are totally incompetent because of the greed and the chaos that we've described already. And the Anzacs get culled relentlessly, but only the good ones. Yeah, the rest of them are in the Illuminati families or the mafias that they run. The first Pazer to come to America was the former Crown Prince of France, Daniel Pazer, 1785 to 1860. He came over about 1805 to the US and married a Kaiser. Yet, slight change for identity and reputational reasons. They had two boys, Adam and Jonas the Whale. Okay, Jonas. And I think that's me to the bottom. So let's go to the Pazer's Piezo tab and see what we find in Australia. It's tragic. So it looks as if I'm finished with the Rothschild tab. But there's a lot below that. That's only where I got to at 5 o'clock this morning. Okay, there's a lot on the Pazers, and there's a lot on presidents, and there's a lot on Lincoln and Nancy Hanks Lincoln, and a lot on the law system. Sexual liaisons, quite sexy. We'll get the wind howling again tonight. Right then, the piezos. Pazer's piezo. And it will not be in colour with the colour of the flags, but it will be quicker this way than me going there. They're charging a fee for me to visit their site now. Yet I've only had access to it for a fortnight. They're in panic. Pinar Willie Piezo. Do you think that could be a South African moniker? Okay. So, these are the first hits that I got. And so not many people still have the gall to use the Piezo name because of the connotations. But these ones are in the New World, in the South Pacific, where the folk are also besotted with rugby. Yeah, that nobody will give a monkeys. And they've got vast tracts of land. They've only got 4 million citizens. Okay? So, Ana Marie Piezo Lopez, they're in Panama. Have you heard of that in a laundering context? These ones are maybe Pilgrim Piezo relatives, yeah, because they're in Massachusetts. Angelo L. Piezo Inc. Treasurer, President, Secretary. Don't know what the product is. Oh, and there's a Chinese Mafia's Piezo. King Can Hing Restaurant. Armand Barnard Piezo. B Vision Apiaries. Yeah, and all of my activities on the beekeeping. Yeah, and even the gods there, if the season has not been correct for the weather, the gods can give the bees a convulsant honey. And I've worked on that issue. And everything that the gods do, yeah, that has to be regulated out by mass screening by chemistry. But the kiwis were more arbitrary than that. And it was safe only if you were eating it in your own country. But if it had to be exported, It was a major issue, and that's why I got involved. Okay? Charles M. Pizzo, First Maintenance Service, Inc., Massachusetts. Cuarto Pizzo, Puerto Rico. De Pizzo, Jose Alexandre Torres, South Africa. Titular, De Pizzo, Jose Alexandre Torres, Dominican Republic. Inactive, Dam Pizzo Lindo, Lindo Wing, in where the Queen has her babies. Yeah, that's Imperial College London, run by Intel, Miss Manning Ambula, and now by the Irish woman, yeah, with the accent. Oh no, sorry, she's gone to St. Andrews. Much posher than Imperial. Dam Pizzo Lindo, South Africa. Oh no, Dominican Republic, South America. So these are the legends, the survivors who are prepared to use the original name. And you should see the Pizzo derivatives that are in Madonna's bloodline. Chichio, I think her name is. Hunter Photographic Services. Daryl J. Pizzo, she's related to the presidential bloodlines too. Dawn E. Pizzo, and she's related to the fortunes of Scotland. Massachusetts again. Galleria Realty Solutions, that's silver, I think. Dawn E. Pizzo, Annalise, South Priest LLC. Yeah, with the pie word in it. That's the American pie joke after all these years. And I forget what the Macleans do. Oh, they're on Sky, and they've come to see me and to have a chat this week again. Del Pizzo Properties, Pizzo means condominium. That's the joke I made about the Durex. Okay, Domenica Pizzo, Copper Bay Associates, Nico Newbury Salon. So no New Zealanders there. Further down maybe. Computer Cab Link Company. Yeah, we know who those employers will be. Okay, every form of transport, every form of communication is tapped. Yeah, that's Rebecca in Chipping Norton, Valerie Jane Lees, your allies. Yeah, in the dismemberment of your children's future. Frank M. Pizzo, Information Marketing Group Inc. Frank M. Pizzo, Image Solution Inc. Frank Toddo. Oh, the Todds. Dominican Republic. Other ones in Pennsylvania. Yeah, the menace of the pen and ink and the plume and the papyrus. Okay, Gerly and Company, Global Bank, Pizzo, Cali, 50. Don't know where that is. Oh, it's Panama too. Global Banking in Panama for laundering purposes. John Pizzo, Dynamic Associates, Massachusetts. Censitas, Massachusetts. Pilgrim Pizzos, all the way to the bank. SMI Systems, Massachusetts, every one of them. Okay, the Pilgrims. Lance Pizzo, Iusettini, MC Services. Michello Pizzo, ADMS International, Florida. Field McConnell, and the air bases, and the Tyndall Air Base, and the demonization of everything that happens because the American government do it so that they can continue with the Protocols of Zion and keep the world in chaos and take us into the Holy Lands to brutalize them and blame Islam for it. Yeah, and that's Mike Tyndall, married to Princess Anne's daughter. Mark D. Pizzo, Lumark Inc. Florida, Sports Enterprises, ADMS International, Florida, Michelle Pizzo, CRNAPA, don't know what that is, Lumark, that sounds a bit like the Light of the World jokes again, Michelle Pizzo, Dignity World, LLC, Florida, Mundo Pizzo, that means global, Dominican Republic. Peter Pizzo. Yeah, that's the non-existent friend of Jesus. L&F Construction Company Inc. Peter Pizzo, Copper Bay Associates. Where did I see the New Zealand Patra family. Yeah, the Pater Noster and the paternal linkage. Yeah, the relatives of Arius Calpurnius Piso. Yeah, were called Paterculus John Patterson with one T. Okay, so Familia Limited, Patra Familia New Zealand, Vision Complete Limited, that could be Specsavers, there's the Pinar name, okay, so that's the rugby linkage to the apartheid people, yeah, that the Kiwis were dead against in those moralist days when they were thinkers. Pinar Willie Piso, Make It Happen, 2012, New Zealand. Piso Domenic, McDonough's Travelling Farm LLC, New Hampshire. Raquel E. Ramos de Piso, Horea, South Africa. Robert A. Piso. Okay, I've given you the picture. It's all over the world, but there's not very many of them prepared to continue trading. Where else? Let's go quickly to Max Goldsmith. Yeah, he's interesting. And we'll finish the video here probably. Okay, he's from Preston. Yeah, that's where they came to fight the summer war in Bermuda. Till, Kaching, Max Goldsmith. Oh, and we've still not gotten to the man that is fourth or fifth on the rich list, called Ellison. I don't know how I managed to miss him on that massive listing. Let's show you Max. So this is the mason behind Bavarian Carve Up out of the Munich Lodge. Look at his name, Maximilian Goldsmith Rothschild of Preston, with links to all